Hi, Gaye DeRusso here with the Majestic Rider. So today I'm going to talk to you about sedation and your gaited horse. So sedation is usually used for dental procedures or if your horse has had an injury and needs to be treated so the vet can handle your horse safely. When they give them sedation, your horse is going to be standing. The reason I want to talk to you about this is that over the years I have noticed that the gaited horses, especially the Tennessee Walkers, are what we call lightweights. They do not take much sedation to actually sedate them. So they usually take half or a quarter dose of a horse of the same size. If your horse is over sedated, the risk is that he can become very wobbly and he could collapse or fall down and injure himself. So if you're new to gaited horses and your vet is new to them as well, just see if they will either give them a quarter of the dose or half of the dose and then slowly give them more if the horse is not sedated enough. That way you do not risk the injury of the horse stumbling and falling and hurting themselves. Our horses already move differently, which a lot of people and vets do not always understand. Horses are built looser than the regular horses. Some of you could call them double jointed. They have laxity in their joints, and especially the walking horses that really overreach underneath themselves in the back end, they can be wobbly in the back end. So if you sedate them, they have a higher possibility of losing their footing when you're walking them back or when you're moving them and falling down and injuring themselves. So just take this into consideration if you're new to the gaited horses and you don't know how much sedation your horse takes when they go to have a procedure. Just request that the vet give them less sedation to start with and then give them more sedation if the horse is not sedated enough. Hope that helps some of you. Take care.